Hi guys, this is Aslam Khan here to teach you true or false. We are going to look into past paper 2018, 2017 and 2016. Before we move on to the content, I want to remind you, please do not forget to subscribe our channel to learn commerce with us in future. And also to get notified about our recent videos, please click the bell button and also put a like and comment on what you are learning and what you need to learn in future with us. So before moving on to this years of past paper, 2018, 17 and 16, I want to remind you, this is Business Studies in Accounting, grade 10 and 11. And this past paper, this true or false question will be mostly based on question number 2, question number 3 and question number 4, every year of past paper. This will be only given on Roman number 2 in all years of past paper. So let's move on to the content one by one. Here you might see a few columns. Here you might, I'll show here. Here you will see some years of past paper which I have represented, 2018, 17, 16. And here I have given explain. So every point which we are going to read now, it's a 6-mark question in every year paper. If you are selecting question number 2, Roman number 2, you will write true or false for 2 marks. But knowing the content is very important when you are doing the question. When you go for question number 3, Roman number 2, 2 marks. Question number 4, Roman number 2, 2 marks. So all the papers will, or in all years paper, 6 marks for sure, this question will be tested. But either you can't score 6 marks out of it because you need to select questions, either 2 from the part B and 2 from the other part, from the past paper you have. Like on one side business studies and on one side accounting, you need to select from 2, 3, 4, you need to select 2 questions when you're doing the paper. Let's move on to the part which we want to discuss. So if you see question number 2 will be mostly based on your grade 10 syllabus, and this is all on first chapter, second chapter and third chapter. But if you see question number 3 is mostly based on grade 11 chapter number 1, and if you see when it comes to question number 4, Roman number 2, this will be tested on chapter number 2, chapter number 3 and chapter number 8 on your grade 11 syllabus. So these are the things you need to know when you're doing the past papers. So as I've given you an idea, let's move on to the paper. Question number 2, Roman number 2. State whether the following statements are true or false. Employees who expect to satisfy different aims from the business belong to the external environment of the business. So you need to know, is it a true or false? You need to know, is employees belonging to external environment or not? Let's move on to the explanation part of this paper. Now you see here, which I have given here, the question number 2, Roman number 2A, I have taken the answers from your textbook itself for your preference. So it's very easy. You might not feel uncomfortable on searching these things. These charts are just there on your textbook itself. So when I am referring, it's very easy for you to refer with me. So if you see your business environment, you have internal environment and you have external environment. Owners, managers, employees belongs to internal environment. Customers, suppliers, competitors, political environment, legal environment, technological environment, economic and global environment belongs to external environment. So the first question is about employees who expect to satisfy different aims from the business belongs to external environment of the business. This is false. So this is wrong. You need to know this is very straightforward because external environment, employees doesn't belong to external environment. Natural resources that are used in business which produce goods and services are known as capital. So you need to know these definitions. From factors of production part. They have given the definition of capital, but they have said natural resource. So is it wrong or right? Let's see. Now let's move on to the part 2. I'll read all the definitions. You find out which definition it belongs to. All the natural resources available are considered as land. It includes resources on the surface of the land as well as resources beneath the land. The mental and physical contribution in a business can be considered as a labor in simple terms. Anything produced by man in order to facilitate manufacturing process is known as capital. Entrepreneurship encompasses the role of organizing factors of production such as land, labor, and capital. Now, if you see the definition, the natural resources is coming from the term land, but they have said it is capital. So the answer is actually wrong. So we need to consider it as false. Right? Right here, false. Then moving on to the third part, if you see, cooperative societies belong to not-for-profit business in private sector. So do they belong to private sector, not-for-profit business? Same in 2018. I'm going to the chart. You see private sector and public sector, profit and not-for-profit is divided under the term called objectives. So we are dividing business organization under objective into 2 objectives. One we said as profit businesses, other one we said as non-profit businesses. Under profit businesses, you have private and public. Under not-for-profit business, you have private and public as same. But if you see in profit, you might see sole proprietorship, partnership, incorporated companies, in public state companies, private for not-for-profit businesses, you might see private operator societies is there. So the question was, is not-for-profit business a private, is cooperative or not-for-profit business under private sector? That was the question. As in way, the answer is correct when it comes to this part. Let's move on to the next content of this. So this is true. So I'll write true here. Business can be categorized as commodity manufacturing business and service providing business. Again, referring to chapter number one, you might see categorization of business, manufacturing businesses, or we can say businesses can be categorized as follows based on the nature of product: as commodity manufacturing business, service providing business. So that's very straightforward. They are given in your textbook. It's true. So moving on to the next part, state whether the following statements are true or false. To know these terms and clearly understand, we have uploaded the videos regarding to these chapters. You can refer it on our channel. Go to our playlist. Go and see, learn under grade 10 and 11 sessions which I have shared to you. So moving on to the next part of this paper, state whether the following statement are true or false as same. The main difference between retail business and wholesale business is the intention of the buyer. So you need to know the difference between a retail business and a wholesale business. A retail business is where you sell a product towards the final consumption. You sell for the consumer directly. But a wholesale business is a person who brings a product and he keeps with an intention of reselling. So intention is going to be different. So it's not going to be the intention of the buyer. So let's move on to the part of the explanation for 2018. If you see here, they have given the objective of retail is to sell goods for final consumption. The objective of wholesale is to sell goods for purpose of reselling. Now you see, I gave a definition, the same definition they have explained here. So looking on to this question, you might understand that. Okay, so understanding this question a bit more, you will be able to represent one thing, that this is a part which you all need to understand, that the retail business and wholesale business has some intention of the buyer, because a buyer purchases from retail business for final consumption, and a wholesaler purchases from the wholesaler, a buyer will be purchasing for one reason. Maybe he might purchase and he might be able to sell for another person, or he might purchase in a bulk purchase. So this is a true when it comes to the answer. I'll write here true, because the intention is different between the buyer. When he's purchasing, as I said, for retail business, he's consuming for his consumption, but for a wholesale business also he will consume for his consumption, but he will purchase in bulk. But in retail business, he will purchase one at a time. So there's a difference between the purchasing behavior. So let's move on to the second part. A check with special processing can be deposited in current account in any commercial bank. So a check with special processing can be deposited in current account in any commercial bank. So let's look, can we deposit the checks? This is what we say special crossing. You need to know there's two type of crossings in your crossing. Number one, we said as general crossing. Number two, we said as special crossing. General crossing, you can just cross it and deposit in any banks. But when it comes to special crossing, you can't do that. If you see the meaning they are given, a check crossed in this way requires to be deposited in an account in the name bank in crossing. So when you have represented a bank inside, you need to only give that check into that relevant bank in order to encash it. Encash means to get into cash method. To convert the check into cash, you need to give it in the bank and get the money back. So that's what we say. When it comes to special crossing and general crossing, there's a big difference. General crossing, you can exchange it in any bank. But a special crossing, if it is the particular bank's name has been mentioned with inside the crossing, you need to exchange on that particular bank. So let's move on. So this is actually false. So I'll write here, you can't exchange in all the banks which you think it's easy, because they have crossed it properly. So you need to go to that particular bank and change it. And while the risk in property insurance is certain, the risk in life insurance is uncertain. You know, normally a risk is uncertain. The meaning of risk means it is something which you can't expect in future. You can't expect what will happen in future. You don't know when will a natural disaster come, right? So you might lose your life. You don't know when your death will come. So nothing is certain in when it comes to insurance. All are uncertain. Risk is uncertain. So you need to remember that. So the term which they have explained here is also false, because they have said here, the risk in property insurance is certain. Even accidents, you never know when you are going to get accident. So it's not certain. You'll always consider it as uncertain. Life insurance is also uncertain, which is correct, but on the particular thing, it's wrong on the first line. The act of the sender The act of the sender in regarding the message is the response in the communication process. Let's move on to communication process. When a sender responds, when the sender send a message, he is not doing a response. It is done by the receiver. Now let's see sender. What does the sender does? You see, sender sends a message through a medium and receiver receive it and he react and provide a feedback. So this is the communication process you need to know. So which means sender is involved in message and medium, whereas receiver is all involved in reaction and feedback. So the question was, the statement was, the act of sending regarding the message is the response in the communication process. He don't do the response, so this is false. Sender doesn't respond, receiver responds. State whether the following statements are true or false. 2018, question number 4, Roman number 2. Planning is the process of investigating whether the planned activities have happened in that order. So I have given some definition in 2018. If you see here, I have taken two type of statement. This is the management functions, chapter number 2 of grade 11. You might see planning, organizing, leading, controlling. So you have controversial problems in these two definitions, which is planning and controlling. Actually, in the question they have given, if you see here, planning is the process of investigating whether the planned activities have happened in that order. So this definition is meeting with the controlling part, not with the planning. If you see, controlling is the process of finding out whether the business activities are implemented as planned, and if not, identifying errors and taking necessary measures to correct them. So you finding out the mistake and finding out why it was not met is a part of controlling, not planning. So planning is like you have a process of determining the objective, what objectives you need to set, and seeing how these objectives will be meeting the standard, how you're going to achieve this type of setting objective, the part of planning. So the definition what they are given is a part is controlling definition, and we need to consider it as false. Then moving on to the next part, if you see, the target market is the share of the market consisting of consumers that a business can satisfy in a more attractive and profitable way. So they are saying that the target market is about satisfying the consumers in a more profitable way. Knowing the terms is very important. The target market is exactly what they have said is correct. Now, if you see this definition, you will find it correct. The share of a market consisting of consumers that a business can satisfy in a more attractive and profitable way is target market. So that's the definition which is given in the textbook. So if you see the meaning, the statement what they are given and the statement goes aligned. So this is true. So actually you consider from the market, you take a share and you target that share in order to satisfy the needs and wants of the people and get a attractable and profitable way. So answer here, it is true. Exactly. It's true. So when it moves on to the third part, it says when selecting an investment, only the risk of that investment should be considered. When you are taking an investment, when you are going to invest, you need to only consider the risk. Let's see what are the factors you need to consider when you are taking an investment. You see aim of investment. What is your main aim? Why you are investing, first of all. The risk of the investment, how much you are going to get in return when you invest. The third thing, the return from the investment. When you invest, how much you get in return. So they are saying the risk of the investment is only considered when you are investing. But actually, it's not the correct term. They are saying factors to be considered when selecting an investment method has three things: aim of investment, risk of investment, return from investment. So all these three things will be considered, not only risk of the investment. So the statement is false because they are saying they are only considering risk of investment, which is false. So I'll take it as false. Then if you see here, the third part, you might see here, the third part and the fourth one, it says that employing some amount of money from the earnings in an effective way with the purpose of having an economic benefit is an investment. So they are given the definition of an investment. So let's look on to the definition which we have taken. Accordingly, investment means any individual investing a certain amount from his earned earnings as savings in an effective method with an expectation of earning an economic return. So the definition and the actual meaning here, statement is going with the same thing, because having some amount of money for your earnings and from your earnings and with the purpose of bringing some economic benefits, you are going to increase your level of money within your hand is a part of investment. So that's the same meaning which they are given on the textbook too. So for it's true. We are done with 2018. Let's move on to 2017 now. Let's start. State whether the following statements are true or false. Things that man should necessarily fulfill not to exist are human needs. So they have given the difference between human needs and human wants. You need to know when you are writing this question. Human needs all about satisfying the basic human, basic requirements to satisfy, to survive. But want is something variable. It's not going to be the same. It's going to be different from one person to another. So moving on to this definition of this question, if you see 2017, needs, they are given a definition. Human needs are requirements that must be fulfilled essentially for existence. So it's something which we need to have. in order to survive. Food, clothing, and shelter are considered as basic human needs. So the statement is true. It's very straightforward. So I don't want to waste time on this. This is a very straightforward answer. So more on the next part. According to the nature of products produced, businesses are classified as public and private businesses. One last question we discussed that business is classified into two ways. One is commodity manufacturing business, and the second is service providing business. So according to this, it is not classified as private and public businesses. If you see the explanation, same thing, commodity and service providing business, but here they have given it is private and public, so it's false. The man-made things used in production is a factor of production called labor. A man-made thing cannot be a factor of production called labor because, as I explained the definition, if you see the labor's meaning, they are given the mental and physical contribution in a business can be considered as labor in simple terms. So a mental and physical contribution and the man-made thing is very different. But if you see here, anything produced by man in order to facilitate. So produced by man in order to facilitate manufacturing process is the term of capital, not the term of labor. So it is false. We can write here false. Then, I'm sorry, I'll record here. Then the liability of the shareholders of a limited company is limited to the capital invested by them. So when you invest and also when the company goes on loss, the amount of losses also becomes limited. That's the actual truth you need to know. Let's see the textbook's answer. When it comes to the fourth one, if you see limited liability, it is advantages of incorporated companies. You can see in grade 10, chapter number 3, limited liability, the liability of shareholders of an incorporated company are limited to the amount of capital they have invested in the company. So the loss also will be limited. That's the reason it becomes an incorporated company. That's the reason we also say it as private limited company and public limited company, because their losses is limited. Then moving on to the third question. Here it is true. I will record it as true. Then moving on to the third question, state whether the following statement are true or false. A bank which lends money on jewelry can insure the pawn jewelry. So you will learn when it comes to insurance, there are three types of principles you need to know. Insurable interest, utmost good faith, and indemnity. So according to this, here they have spoken about insurable interest. Insurable interest is where you need to understand that the business has given some sort of money for the pawn jewelry by the customers. But when the customer keep the jewelry and take the money from them, they have a responsibility to safeguard in their jewelry. So they will keep an insurance on securing that asset. So this is also part of true. I think I have not, I have given a agreed definition for this. It says insurable interest, the legal right to obtain an insurance coverage for a life or for a property is known as insurable interest. Now, if you see husband and wife has insurable interest for each other's life, husband say insurable interest on wife and wife take insurable interest on husband. Property insurance, like the legal owner of such property has an insurable interest. Like when you go and give the pawning to that people, they are given you some sort of money, but still it's your responsibility to safeguard it. So that's the reason it becomes an insurable interest. If you see here the third example, it is telling with the example they have given on the question. It says a creditor has an insurable interest over the life of the debtor up to the value of the loan. So if the debtor doesn't pay the money back, of course the creditor is going to go through a hard time. So he need to cover up the money from the debtor by having an insurable interest. He has an insurable interest until he gets the money from them. So it's the same way, once you go and give the pawning goods, the pawning business should ensure that keep them as safe as possible, because one day you will come and ask the product from the bank. So here you can say it is true. And moving on to the next thing, the feedback is not essential to complete the communication process. We studied the same chart. Without a feedback, a communication process will not be complete. It will become inadequate. So then, of course, they're saying without feedback, a complete communication process will be there, it seems, but it's wrong. So we say it as false. The permission given by a bank to withdraw money exceeding the balance in the savings account is the bank overdraft facilities. Now, you need to understand one thing. In savings account, you can't take money more than the balance what you have. In savings account, what you have put, only you can take. You can't take more than that. So if you take more than that, it is not known as savings account. It is known as current account. So here you are taking money more than your savings account, means the definition itself wrong. But a bank overdraft facility is only provided for current account. So here they are saying the bank is giving money to the savings account more than the money they should have. So this is wrong. Then we move on to the next part. It says A country bringing in products from another country. Have I given any explanation? If you see here, the explanation will see ability to obtain bank overdraft facilities. Bank overdraft facilities can be obtained by getting permission from the bank to write checks for a balance which exceeds the deposited balance in the current account. If you see this, the term there is a current account, so it's not savings account. So I have given you definitions from the textbook to show that what I say is correct from the textbooks which you are studying. So it's better to know why it is correct, and you need to know which page it is. So this is chapter number 1 on grade 11. So you can refer, I think, 1.4 on the banking services. If you see D, let's move on to the 2017 explanation D part. A country bringing in products from another country is exported. When you bring the product into your country, what do you say? You see the definition. Then I can explain you. Import trade is bringing goods from a country or countries to this country. Export trade is selling domestic goods to a foreign country or countries. Which means when you sell your product towards outside country, it becomes export. When you bring a product to your country, it becomes import. So you need to know the difference. Import is bringing, export is selling outside. So here they are given in a vice versa way. They have said that export is about bringing the product, which is again false. The term is wrong. So let's move on to the next part, question number 4. As I said, question number 4, Roman number 2, is mostly based on chapter number 2, 3, and 8. So you need to know these chapters when you are doing question number 4. So Roman number 2. One of the main objectives of Securities and Exchange Commission of Sri Lanka is to maintain the share market in fair and orderly manner. Before we move on to the content of this part, I want to remind you what is Securities and Exchange Commission. They are responsible of running the share market in our country, and they are the people who see what happens to the share market in an industry and who is trading fairly and who is not trading fairly. So they are the people who manages all the shares in this country. So that's what we say, Securities and Exchange Commission. So what is the main objective? The main objective is to keep the share market in fair and orderly manner. Let's see the definition for this. The Securities Exchange Commission of Sri Lanka, in order to monitor and regulate the Colombo Stock Exchange transaction, the Securities and Exchange Commission of Sri Lanka has been established by an Act of Parliament. The prime objective of this body is to protect the investors by maintaining a fair manner. So the definition and the statement is correct, because they're saying that they need to protect the investors by the fair manner. So they are protecting the share market in a fair manner. Both are same. So we can write here. Then moving on to the next part, when risk of an investment increases, expected return also increases. There's no such definition for this, but it's just a general term. So I have given a term when it comes to risk of investment. You see, they have said when risk of an investment increases, expected return also increases. The more higher the risk, higher the return. That's what they are trying to say in a better way, if I say. That's the meaning they're saying in the statement. So more risk you take, more return you will get. So this is basic understanding. Of course, if you take a lot of risk, then of course you will get a lot of income. So we'll say that's true. But I have also given a definition there. It's not that going tally with that, but for your understanding, where the invested money could be obtained back and expected return is certain is considered. So what they're trying to say is the more you invest, the more money you will get in return is what they are meant. Here, the money you have invested, you will know how much you will get in return. That's what they are trying to say. When it comes to C, only the process from designing a product to delivering it to the customer is marketing. So you need to remember, guys, marketing is not about just designing the product and just giving to the customer. It's about designing, making it in a presentable manner, giving a quality feature what the customers are expecting, and satisfying their human needs and wants is a part of marketing. But they are just designing, and also we'll see the definition of what they're trying to say. Marketing is the process of creating and offering a valuable product to satisfy human needs and wants. Now, if you see here, satisfying human needs and wants is one of the main scope of marketing, but in the statement, they didn't say about it. It's about designing a product. So the definition goes wrong. Then we say it as false. You need to know these terms. You don't want to buy hard these terms. Just remember these terms, then only you can score on this area. Management is necessary to business to maximize the use of limited resources. So they're saying that you need to take maximum use of your limited resources. Let me move on to the explanation part. If you see, management is the process of planning, organizing, leading, and controlling the resource owned by business in order to achieve objectives of business efficiently and effectively. Now, there's two terms which you need to know, efficiently and effectively. So this is where the statement's answer has been explained here. Efficiently means you are taking the maximum use of the resource, or you say you are reducing the wastages. Minimum, you keep your wastages at minimum, or you say maximum usage of resources. We say it as efficiently. So efficiently means maximum usage of resources, whereas effectively means taking the product towards the correct parties is what we say effectively. So management is enhancing maximum utilization of resources. That's true, because they are given the term efficiently here. So I'm not speaking about planning, organizing, leading, and controlling, but I'm speaking about efficiently the term, because efficiently is the term which they are expecting on this question. So only the management is necessary to a business to maximize the use of limited resources. It's true. So I hope you guys understood 2017. I'm a bit fast on explaining the reason. On 2018, I took a little bit of time to explain what's important. But in 2017, you guys already know what we have learned. So we are moving and sticking into the points, which is very important. Let's move on to 2016 without wasting our time. To learn more on these terms and videos, we have our playlist. Go and refer our playlist. You'll learn a lot of things on our playlist. You'll be able to learn a lot from us. And you'll be, you know, if you go to our playlist, you will be having all the years of past papers. It's very easy to refer with me. And you have doubts, you can put in the comment section. And please do not forget to subscribe our channel. State where the following statements are true or false. The person who purchases goods and services for final consumption is consumer. This is something which they have directly given. It's something that you need to always understand. When you are selling a product towards your towards a consumer, the consumer is going to consume the product at final point. So that's what we say, final consumption. So you need to understand that when a consumer is purchasing the product for his consumption, he is becoming the final, final consumer is consuming at the final moment. Then of course he is becoming the person who will consume the product at final consumption. So this is very true. There's no special definition for that. They are not given in your syllabus, in your textbook. If you see, I have kept it blank here. There's no proper definition for consumer or for customer. You need to know that consumer are the people who purchase for their own purpose. That's the actual meaning. But when it comes to the next part, according to the objective, businesses are classified mainly as public sector businesses and private sector businesses. As we studied on the previous 2018 chart, you might see this 2016 explanation. A, I have kept it blank. B, if you see, according to objective, your business is divided into profit business, not for profit business. But here they are given, according to the objective, businesses are classified mainly as public sector business and private sector business, which is false. So it should be profit business and non-profit businesses. Owners of a business are internal environment factor, while customers are external environment factors. As I explained on the previous chart in 2018, owners are internal, customers are external, which is true. So you can write here, true. Then when it comes to human needs are different while wants are limited. Actually, human needs are not different. It's going to be the same. Like, as I said, food, shelter is something which people need to have. But wants are like not limited. It's going to change from one person to another. One person likes to ride Mercedes. One person likes to ride Audi. So the difference in perspective is going to be always different when it comes to wants. But need is going to be the same, like clothes, shelter, basic needs are that way. So let's move on to saying it's false, because human needs are not different. It's going to be the same. But wants are going to be varied. State whether the following statements are true or false. Question number 3. In insurance, the party who receives the insurance cover is termed as insured, while the party who provides the insurance cover is termed as insurer. Now, if you see here, I've given the parties involved in insurance. There are 3 parties involved in insurance. Number 1, we said as first party, second party, and third party. First party is the party who obtains the insurance coverage. So when you obtain the insurance coverage or you receive the insurance coverage, we say it as insured. And when you give the insurance coverage, the party who is giving the insurance coverage, which means the insurance company, is known as the insurer. So third party, all the other parties who will be influenced by an insurance contract, for example, the passengers and other vehicles on the roads will become the third party when a vehicle is insured. So when you take a vehicle and when you ride and go and knock on another vehicle, the vehicle which is getting affected by you is known as the third party. So there are 3 parties, first party, second party, and third party. First party is you who is going to get the coverage of insurance, and second party is what the company is giving you. If Selling Insurance is giving, Selling Insurance become insurer and you become insured. And third party is becoming any people who are getting affected by your activity. So let's see the definition which they are given in 2016, question number 3, Roman number 2a. They are said in insurance, the party who received the insurance cover is termed as insured, correct. While the party who provide the insurance cover is termed as insurer. Again, it's correct. So I'll write here true, which we explain on the terms very clearly. Transmitting messages, information, and ideas among different people in an organization. So you see, in an organization, using different modes is external environment. So when you are communicating between your organization, inside your organization, it is inside. So it becomes internal environment. When you communicate outside the company, it becomes external. But they're saying different modes, so you don't get confused. It's different channels, but they're saying you can speak in notice board, you can even message through email or WhatsApp, whatever, but inside an organization or through some sort of intranet network. So all comes under different modes, but still it is inside in an organization. So we say it as one organization, we can consider it as a part of internal environment. Now, if you see here, the explanation which I have given, internal communication and external communication, this is the definition. This means communicating messages, information and ideas via various mediums between different parties within an organization. So within an organization is internal communication. But when it comes to external communication, is the communication of a business with external individual and external organization. So you move out of the organization and you finalize your communication. That's what we say, external organization. So moving on to the third part of this question. Purchasing required foods by a student from the school canteen is wholesale business. Now, if you see here, you are purchasing, but not in bulk. When you go and purchase a food, you are going to consume for yourself. So you are not going to do a wholesale business on canteen area. It's very practical. So it becomes false because you are consuming for yourself. It becomes a retail business, not a wholesale business. So I'll say it's false. You will never buy in bulk and eat. You are not going to eat in abundant of buns. Like if you want to eat morning, because you will not eat 50 rotis or 50 chapatis, whatever it is, guys. So drawee of a check is always a commercial bank. So we need to know this type of parties who are involved in a check. Given you this explanation here, you might see there are three major parties involved in transaction related to checks. There are drawer, drawee, payee. Okay, so who is drawer, who is drawee, who is payee? That's what you need to know. The drawer is the person who writes and signs a check. So when you write a check, you are the person who is going to write the check. You become the drawer. And it can be most of the time who is known as current account holder, or you can also say the person who writes the check is known as the drawer. It is the bank of the drawer. The drawee is the bank in which the current account is made. So the bank becomes the drawee. The question was, is bank the drawee? Yes, of course, the bank is the drawee. Payee, the person whose name is written on the check and has the right to receive the payment mentioned in the check, is the payee. So when drawer writes something to someone, when he says that Aslam is writing to you, so when I write the check to you, then of course you become my payee. So you will receive the amount from the bank. But drawee is the bank who is going to give the money to payee. So they take the money from drawer, they give to payee. So you need to understand these three type of parties who are related to the check, because we will not go wrong if you know these definitions very clearly. So drawee of a check is always a commercial bank. So now the question is it always a commercial bank? Is the question. The commercial bank they have meant is not only one bank. It can be all the banks they are meaning as commercial bank. The term commercial bank, some people consider commercial bank as like one commercial bank comes under all the commercial banks. I want to make it clear. The commercial banks, all the banks comes under the term called commercial bank. So you need to understand, drawee of a check always becomes a commercial bank. So this is true. Let's move on to the last part of this year, 2016. State whether the following statements are true or false. Dividends are the returns received to the partners for the employed capital in a partnership. A partner never receives a dividend. A shareholder receives a dividend. A partner receives profit. So let's see, have I given any explanation? A and B, I have not given any explanation, because it's very straightforward. It's a partnership. Partners get a profit, or they can receive a salary for the work what they have, what they are giving, but they don't get a dividend. And this is false, actually. I'll start with false. Then we have investing money in bank current account is a source of investment which receives a higher interest. Again, another straightforward question. They are saying that if you invest in bank current account's money is not an investment. It is a business transaction, so it doesn't become an investment first of all. And you don't get a big interest income, because maybe you might get interest income in savings account or fixed deposit, but not in bank current account, because there's a transaction. You use that account for your transaction, so it becomes false. Then the last two, planning is the process of determining the objectives of a business and deciding on suitable ways and means of achieving them. So this is the definition they have given for planning. We can see is the definition meeting. Planning is the process of determining the objectives of a business and determining the activities to achieve these objectives. The same definition which has been given here, there's no different on that, so it becomes true. So you need to know the definition somewhat when you are doing these questions. In the last question, again, in 2018, we saw this question, target market is a segment of consumers that can be satisfied attractively as well as effectively by a business. So they are speaking about satisfaction. They are speaking about satisfaction, and they are saying that you can satisfy them in attractive manner and also in an effective manner. So normally, target market's definition is about satisfying the people by taking a portion of from the market. You will satisfy them as maximum. That's what the target market speaks. Let's see the definition. The share of the market consists of consumers that a business can satisfy in more attractive and profitable way. Again, the definition, so we can go along with that. True. So I hope you guys understood what we have learned today. I want to remind you one thing. If you wanted to get good marks in your business studies and accounting grade 10 and 11 exams, or in your main O-level exams, you need to have one thing, persistence and patience to learn more with us. And also, if you really see all the videos of ours, you'll be able to increase your knowledge, and this will surely help you to get a good marks on your exams. And also remember, please do not forget to subscribe our channel to learn more with us, and comment what you need more and what did you learn from this, and is this video a lot helpful for your studies. Or if you want more videos, which areas you need to cover, you can inform us through your comment. And never forget to press the bell button, because bell button will notify you what are the videos we are going to upload in future.